In July 2000, Shannon Ainsley was a surf-crazy 15-year-old from South Africa. A tourist was shooting their holiday video as Shannon surfed Nahoon Reef, a world-class surf location, with one serious drawback.
Nahoon Reef is definitely famous for its sharks and shark attacks.
There had been 16 attacks and 2 fatalities in the area in the previous 20 years.
I was so scared of Nahoon Reef, and everyone would always say their prayers before they surf and say, "Hey God, please keep us safe today."
The risk is greatest in winter, when billions of sardines migrate along the coast. Pursued by tens of thousands of dolphins and seals. And a large number of hungry sharks.
I think I had been surfing for about an hour or hour and a half.
Shannon had no idea that there were any sharks around.
I started paddling for this wave, and just before I was about to stand up and ride the wave, 2 sharks came for me.
The shark on Shannon's left bit his hand and surfboard, sending his legs flying in the air. Then it dragged him and his surfboard under, just as another shark moved in. The second shark narrowly missed Shannon as he was pulled below the waves.
And the shark on the right was going for my head and my shoulders. But it missed me, fortunately, because the shark on the left got me first.
A split second seemed like forever as Shannon confronted his attacker.
I remember just staring at the shark face to face with its mouth wide open. And I could see his one eye staring right into my face. And I could see all of its teeth. The fears and the thoughts and the emotions I was going through were just indescribable. I was 15 years old. I wanted to surf, and yeah, these sharks just attacked me, and I'm about to die. And then the shark swam past me to my right and around me, and then bumped me from behind and just shoved me forward. So I swam to my board, and as I did that, I saw my fingers hanging off my hand and blood just squirting and rushing out of my hand and fingers. No one stayed in the water to help me out. Everyone just bailed and left me in the water all to myself. And at the same time, the ocean went dead flat. And I was looking to my right and to my left all the time, waiting for these sharks to come back for me any second. I prayed and said, "Hey, Jesus, please, like, I need some help here. Please help me out." And all of a sudden, this wave came out of nowhere, and all my fear just disappeared.
As he caught the wave to the beach, Shannon's fellow surfers finally came to his aid.
One guy tied a leash around my arm, and another guy wrapped a towel around my hand to prevent the bleeding.
Shannon's brother rushed him to hospital.
The first thing I asked the nurse was whether I was going to lose my hand or not, and she was like, "No, you'll be okay." And after that moment, I was extremely happy and relaxed and stoked to be alive.
Being attacked by 2 great white sharks might seem like the ultimate bad luck, but to then walk away almost unscathed, how lucky is that?
There was some kind of divine intervention, because there was no way I should have lived and survived that at all.
But who says lightning never strikes twice? Only 4 years later, Shannon would again come face to face with a great white shark.
My heart just sank and dropped, and I thought that it was happening all over again. I heard this commotion, and I turned around, and here's this 3-meter great white shark attacking this guy, Joseph.
The shark had Joseph's board in its mouth. Shannon well remembered what it was like to be left alone when he was attacked.
I turned around and went back to him. And the shark was like a meter away from me, and I could have reached out and touched the shark. So I put him on the surfboard and we kind of paddled towards shore together. And at that stage, the shark swam underneath the water and disappeared with his surfboard in its mouth.
Authorities later found the board, bitten into three pieces. Incredibly, both surfers escaped unscathed. When we enter the water, we enter the shark's world. We are the visitors.
People have this preconception that the oceans are our backyard swimming pool. They're not, that's the wild out there.
I'd hate to think the number of times that the sharks did actually see me before this happened. Most of the time they see you and you never see them.
Although every human shark encounter is different, many survival stories have striking similarities. The moment survivors come face to face with the shark is seared into their memories.
Every time I retell the story, I get a little bit fuzzy and nervous and my voice cracks. Yeah, it's like reliving it.
Despite their gruesome injuries, many feel no pain. And even those who lose limbs don't blame the sharks.
Although a shark ripped my life apart, took my arm, took my leg, I don't hold any ill thought to any shark at all.
I definitely think that when a shark attacks a human, it's a mistaken identity. So that's why sometimes they'll bite the surfer and let go of him.
These survivors all had the bad luck to be in the wrong place at the worst possible time.